What's going on, family? This is Scrapbook Boxing Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuffs series. We're going to continue with boxing's history in the 1900s through the eyes of the Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuffs series. We're going to kick it off with Benny Leonard, the Ghetto Wizard. His actual name was Benjamin Lenore. Now, Benny Leonard was born April 7th, 1896 in New York. He died April 18th, 1947. He was 51 years of age at the time of his death. He died in New York's St. Nicholas Arena. He was refereeing a match in 1947. And his heart gave out and he collapsed in the ring. He was pronounced dead later that afternoon. Now, Benny Leonard had a fighting record of 90 wins, 70 knockouts, 6 losses. And he was knocked out himself 5 times. Began his professional debut October 14th, 1911. Benny Leonard fought such great fighters as Johnny Dundee, the Scotchwop, Jimmy McLaughlin, Rocky Kansas, Freddie Welch, Richie Mitchell, and Ted Kidd Lewis, just to name a few. He was one fighter that I can't make up my mind whether he should be ranked number one as the greatest lightweight of all times. It's either him or Joe Gans. We will eventually get to Joe Gans in this series. Perhaps we can make a determination then. But right now I have Joe Gans and Benny Leonard top one, collectively, greatest lightweight champions of all times. So let's take a look at Benny Leonard's career. Now, Benny Leonard would face Rocky Kansas. Rocky Kansas was a determined fighter. He was born April 21st, 1895 in Buffalo, New York. And Rocky Kansas was some fighter. He was in there with some of the best fighters of his time. And Benny Leonard would be one of them. Very good fighter was Rocky Kansas. As we look into the Police Gazette scrapbook, we see Benny Leonard and Rocky Kansas. Now, Benny Leonard's to your right, and Rocky Kansas is to your left. Shaking hands at the beginning of the match. Benny Leonard, as you can see, is to your right. Rocky Kansas is bowing in towards your left. Rocky Kansas, at this point of his career, is the challenger. Benny Leonard is the champion. If you can see here, there's really no contest between the two men. Benny Leonard looks on as Rocky Kansas is being examined by the referee. He's about to go down. And this fight will end very quickly. Referee stops the match as Rocky Kansas goes down. Benny Leonard looks like he's trying to help Rocky Kansas to his feet. But there's really no contest in this match. Benny Leonard was a superior boxer. And as I said, I have him and Joe Gans collectively number one greatest lightweight champion of all time. Benny Leonard would begin his professional career in 1911. And very quickly, he would earn the lightweight championship of the world. As you see here, Benny Leonard knocks out rugged challenger Rocky Kansas. He knocks him out in the 6th round. Let's examine this fight a little bit more. And we'll see Benny Leonard holds on to his crown through hard press by Rocky Kansas. The lightweight champion outpoints Buffalo, the Italian, in 15 rounds. This was at the Garden. But is painfully weakened by efforts to keep under 135 pounds. He drops challenger actually in the 11th round. It was an 11th round knockout. Now the issue with Benny Leonard, he always had problems with his weight. And he was always forced to weigh in at 135. And at that time they had same day weigh-ins. As a matter of fact, at that time they weighed in the ring. seconds before the fight began. They had their gloves put in on the ring, inside the ring. It was a lot of different circumstances that they had to face. So there were no shortcuts at the time that Benny Leonard would fight in the early 1900s. Leonard to box Rice for title in England. Now this entire book is Benny Leonard. And here you have Benny Leonard knocks out Pinky Mitchell. Lightweight champion gets good start for summer campaign. Nearly a riot at ringside in Chicago. Now you had a lot of great Chicago fighters. You had Bonnie Ross. He was an outstanding lightweight and welterweight. He had Ray Miller, fantastic, hard-punching lightweight out of Chicago. Johnny Bratton, many great fighters in the lightweight and welterweight divisions. Benny Leonard was out of New York, and he took on the best of them. Here you have Benny Leonard and the Scotch Wop, Johnny Dundee. He had a feud, one of long standing. Now, Benny Leonard would fight fighters such as you can see here, Special Delivery Hearse. New York featherweight gave a lot of fighters problems. And he was a very, very good boxer. He would face Brooklyn, New York's outstanding lightweight, Phil Bloom. Phil Bloom was another good fighter. He was out of Brooklyn, New York. Very, very good jab Phil Bloom had. And he would be another opponent for the ghetto wizard, Benny Leonard. Benny Leonard would face Brooklyn's own Soldier Barfield, another outstanding fighter. Now, Soldier Barfield at the time had a fighting record of 112, 54, 26, fought him in Madison Square Garden, and he defeated Soldier Barfield. And this is somewhat of a neighborhood rivalry, because Soldier Barfield had a great reputation of interrupting a winning streak. Very good fighter was Soldier Barfield. Benny Leonard would face Patsy Cline. Now Patsy Cline had a fighting record of 50-27-3. Fought him at Atlantic City AC, New York. Now, Benny Leonard would eventually face Paulie Walker out of Trenton, New Jersey. He wound up becoming a middleweight, but he was a fantastic lightweight at the time that Benny Leonard would face him. Dynamite fighter was Paulie Walker. Now, to give you an idea how good of a fighter Paulie Walker was... He was born October 16th, 1909, died June 24th, 1987. And he was in there with guys like 6 Second Power. He won one and lost one with him. 6 Second Power was a phenomenal fighter. He fought Holman Williams. At the time, Holman Williams had a fighting record of 46-2. He fought him in Madison Square Garden. Two different occasions, lost to him both times, but he was in there with Holman Williams. He fought Coco Kidd. At the time, Coco Kidd had a fighting record of 99-26-5. He fought him in Baltimore, and he would lose to Coco Kidd. That fight took place May 2nd, 1938. Holman Williams was August 5th, 1937. Phenomenal fighter was Paulie Walker. And he would face Benny Leonard towards the end of his career. Now, Benny Leonard defeats Lou Tender The champion is hard-pressed. Now, the thing with Lou Tendler, he was a southpaw. Very fast with his feet and hands. He was tall for his weight division. He was a great Philadelphia fighter. And he was very tricky. He knew the tricks. Benny has hands full with Philadelphia lightweight and great 12-round battle at Boyle's 30 Acres. Now, Boyle's 30 Acres was in New Jersey. And as you can see here, Jersey City, New Jersey. And they had great fights in Boyle's City Acres. Boyle's 30 Acres. Fantastic fight that was with Benny Leonard and Lou Tendler. As I say, Lou Tendler was a fascinating southpaw. One of the greatest of all times. And I explained to you, this entire book is Benny Leonard. I have 80 books that specialize in a fighter, each book. One of them is Benny Leonard. I have Harry Greb. They all have their own books. And, you know, I got to take care of those books. But this is Benny Leonard and Lou Tendler. And let's take a look. Lou Tendler. You see, Lou Tendler to your right and Benny Leonard with the robe on to your left. They're about to begin their match. And like I said, Lou Tendler was an outstanding Philadelphia lightweight. Lou Tendler to your left, and Benny Leonard to your left. Beautiful jab by Benny Leonard. Splits the guard. As you can see, the southpaw position of Lou Tendler. Leonard goes down. Tendler raises his arms as though he feels as though there's an upset in the making. Let's take a look at something here. Ringside scenes at the title bout between Benny Leonard and Lou Tendler. Very good fight between these two men. As Lou Tendler and Benny Leonard congratulate one another on a superb lightweight championship bout. Here again, you have Benny Leonard and Lou Tendler. Leonard regains best form, defeats Tendler easily in 15-round title bout. Benny swarms all over Philadelphia, but fails to knock him out. 65,000 witness scrap at Yankee Stadium in New York. So this is a return go between Benny Leonard and Lou Tendler. They fought in front of a crowd of 65,000 at Yankee Stadium Baseball Stadium. Benny Leonard was some fighter, I gotta tell you. Leonard flaps his hands. Match with Tendler is off. Leonard stops willing in 14th round. Now, eventually, Benny Leonard would retire from the ring. He was an undefeated lightweight champion that earned a ton of money. But he promised his mother, if he ever got hurt in the ring, whether it was a broken hand or a swollen eye, he would retire. And that's what he did. But eventually in 1929, he would make a comeback because he would lose his money in the stock market. And after a few tune-up fights, he would wind up getting in there with the young Jimmy McLaughlin from Vancouver, Canada. And he would be stopped. First time in his career. Tribute to Benny Leonard as artist and gentleman. Let's take a look at a few opponents of Benny Leonard. Now, Benny Leonard would face the Scotswap, Johnny Dundee. Outstanding fighter was Johnny Dundee. I have him ranked number 9, along with Benny Leonard and Tony Canzanieri, greatest fighters of all times. Here you have Charlie White. Fantastic fighter from Chicago. Ever Hammer. Another Chicago fighter. And Benny Leonard opponent. Here you have Benny Leonard himself. Now what I'm showing you are my Police Gazette boxing exhibit card collections. Richie Mitchell. Here you have Jack Britton. Now these fighters alone trump the average fighter's opponent resume. It just goes to show why Benny Leonard, along with Joe Gans, greatest lightweight champions of all time. I always wondered what it would be like if Benny Leonard would have faced Babe Herman out of San Francisco, California. Mushy Callahan, New York junior welterweight champion. Bud Taylor, who was a phenomenal bantamweight out of Fort Wayne. Johnny Kilbane. Cleveland, Ohio. He had great fights with Johnny Dundee, Scotswell. Here you have Eugene Creek, France. Fantastic featherweight. Ted Kitt Lewis. Out of London, England. That'd have been something to see. I have so much to show you of Benny Leonard in so little time. But I think you get the idea. Benny Leonard, one of the greatest lightweight champions of all time, came around in the 1900s when fighters were fighters. And because of his accomplishment, he was placed on the cover of Ring Magazine in 1948. And this came after his death in 1947 when he collapsed in the ring in St. Nicholas Arena. Salute to Benny Leonard. Outstanding lightweight champion. Thanks for hanging in there with me. Scrapbook Boxing, Museum of the Forgotten Fisticuffs series. All great fights and all great fighters will never be forgotten on my channel. This is part 2 of Great Fighters of the 1900s. Look out for part 3. Salute.